Welcome to the presentation of our poster for the project named The Impact of Law Research in South African Courts by Dani and Helian. We'll be taking you through our poster content. We'll be going through the introduction, the purpose of our research. We'll discuss the methodology we used and approach we took. We'll discuss experiments that we ran, also look at the results, and lastly, share some insights on our Shiny app we developed for detailed exploration of our results. It is common practice to measure the impact of academic research in other academic research, measures that include the H index, impact factor, etc. UP's law faculty, however, wants to understand the impact of law research in the courts of South Africa. The purpose of our research is to define and explore measures of impact for law research in South African courts through graph theory and subsequent node level analysis of the network to identify influential authors. Our goals are to compare and document different metrics for research impact and to identify seminal research that has lasting impact. The first step was to transform three volumes of Fontes Juris, a published book that contains source references of the law noted in South African Superior Court cases since 1828, into structured data using text mining and decision tree algorithm to enable graph network modeling. The author, publication, and judgment titles needed to be extracted from the unstructured data. The data processing step enabled the extraction of structured elements after the three Fontes Juris PDFs have been transformed into text data. The result was a string list of 160,000 rows of noisy, unstructured data. We then used crowdsourcing to tag and annotate 10% of the total lines as either author, publication, or judgment lines. We engineered features to subsequently develop a decision tree algorithm that would help us to further clean our data. The result was a clean data set that contains 4,029 authors and 15,766 judgments. The next step involved the modeling of the network. A two-mode network, author and judgment pairs, was created to allow for centrality measures to be calculated. The initial modeling approach was to deliver a two-mode network for the author and judgment fields from the transformed Fontes Juris text data. The result is a directed named two-mode iGraph network object as per the figure, with 19,000 odd nodes and 67 odd edges. The two-mode network resulted in a very sparse, low-density model. The two-mode network was subsequently transformed into a one-mode network, resulting in an author node only network with 60 times higher density. The result of this transformation was an undirected weighted network with 4,000 nodes and 84,000 edges. A node level analysis was executed by calculating the following centrality measures for the one mode network: degree centrality, eigenvector centrality, closeness centrality, betweenness centrality, and page rank centrality. The aforementioned centrality measures were compared with traditional bibliometric indices. These included the H index, M quotient, and the G index for the same collection of data. The centrality measures was able to identify the most influential actors, being Foote, Grotius, and Halsbury, as influential authors in South African courts. The figure shows a judgment citation count of a span of 165 years for the most influential author of all, Foote. The insights from the research became pertinent once the Shiny app version of the results were viewed and the graphs could be interactively explored. The Shiny app has tabs that allow you to follow along with the process from the Fontes Juris data, explaining in detail all the graph theory centrality measures, as well as the bibliometric measures. These are the measures we use to define and compare the impact of a particular author. It then allows you to click actual interactive graph network nodes for the various centrality measures, where you can drag out the nodes to see how many connections a node has, or view a particular author's position in the network through a drop-down menu. The ultimate view is the impact measure comparison, where you get the opportunity to select any author and view the ranking in the network for each of the 8 impact measures, 5 from network analysis and 3 from bibliometrics. Let's take a quick tour of our Shiny app. I'll now take you through a quick tour of our Shiny app. Here you see we mentioned tabs. The first tab is Fontes Juris, explain what Fontes Juris is, how we went about the data preparation, transforming from a two-mode to a one-mode network, detailing the iGraph objects, and here's initial renders of the noisy two-mode network visualization and a one-mode network visualization. And here we see a more nuanced network here, an example of between a centrality visualization for a one-mode iGraph object. Then we go to the tab that defines impact. So what's network analysis? Here's our three questions we want to answer. And here under centrality measures, you can view degree centrality with an example graph. And the nodes weighted according to the degree centrality. Theory explanation, there's betweenness centrality, node E with the highest betweenness centrality, closeness centrality, eigenvector centrality, and lastly page rank centrality for the example network. And it also gives you the intuition for each of the measures. For example, eigenvector centrality, the underlying idea is the power of your friends is your power of influence. Then we go to the bibliometric measures, the H index. Here you can see the top 20 authors based on the H index from 1 to 21. The M quotient, same, the top 20 authors. And also for the G index, a quick explanation of what the G index is and showing the top 20 authors based on the G index. Here you can dive into the actual centrality results. This is for the degree centrality network. The network is already filtered to the author with the highest degree centrality, which is foot. Here's the top 20 shown as well. And now you can interactively drag out nodes and view their degree centrality. This one is ranked 66 out of 912. Here's foot. You can drag that network out, you can zoom in, so it's a nice interactive graph. And we'll just go to a different one. Eigenvector centrality. Here you can select a different node and zoom in to find that node. Here you can see Halsbury, which is also quite an influential author, and you can drag out Halsbury. And this is the exciting part where you can compare the impact measures. If we search for foot, you can see foot is for the degree centrality, betweenness centrality, closeness centrality, eigenvector centrality, and page rank centrality, very highly ranked. But for the bibliometric indices, the H index, M quotient, and G index, for the here's an anomaly for this author. You can take any other author, Fisser, and the rank for the 8 different measures will be shown here. This is our Shiny app.